Excel offers a couple different options to protect your workbooks and your Excel files. For this example, we'll be working with customer data or order data. So these are orders, and we're going to want to protect this sheet so that if we have employees working at our company or just on a personal computer, and the only way you want someone to access this is by knowing a password. If you go to File, Info, Protect Workbook, this will have a dropdown. So now we can encrypt it with a password. So for this example, we'll just use password as our password. So when we click OK and re-enter, this workbook is now protected by a password. So if we close it and then reopen the file, the next time we open it, we'll be prompted with a password to input before we can open the file. So we'll put password in, and if you enter the correct password, you can now open and select your data and have access to the file. Another way to protect an Excel sheet, let's say you want people to be able to see it, but not edit it in any way. We'll do the same thing. Go to Info, Protect Workbook, and you can either protect a current sheet, which will be the one you have selected. So there's only one sheet in this. So if we hit Protect, so what you're going to want to do is choose what you want people to be able to do. If you want someone to be able to format cells, you can select this. Or if you want them to be able to insert or delete rows or columns, you can also do that. But if you want people just to be able to select a cell, whether it's locked or unlocked, you can put a password. We'll use the same password. So now if we hit OK, re-enter, hit OK again. So now say we try to change the previous year. It will come up with an error. The cell or chart you're trying to change is on a protected sheet. So now if we want to unprotect the sheet for editing, you can go to File, Info, Protect Workbook, Protect Current Sheet. And to unprotect the sheet, we'll just put in the password we made before. And to do the same to a password protected one that we previously went over, if we reopen this Excel file, to unprotect it, you'll go to Info, Protect Workbook, and Encrypt with Password. And so for this, we can just enter nothing and click OK. So if we save that and then reopen it, there will no longer be a password protecting this file. And those are the quickest and easiest ways to protect your sheet. And there's one last example. So if we go to the income statement, say you want to make this final for the year where no one can come in and edit anything at any time, including yourself, you can go to Info, Protect Workbook, and mark as final. So it is indicating that the editing is complete and that the final version will be available. And that means there is no editing at any time. And there is a way that you can hit edit anyway, but this is letting people know that this workbook is marked as final. And say we close this and try to edit any cell, we won't be able to since it is a final version of the sheet. And those are the quickest ways to protect your Excel files. It's extremely useful to put a password on if you have different people going in and out of cells, or on your personal computer, you just want to be able to protect any spreadsheets you have or any personal information or customer information you have. That's all I have for you in this video. If you enjoyed the content, please like and subscribe, and thanks for watching.